headed to Big Cedar for the weekend here. It's Friday. And I'm going to meet my brother Dennis and two other old friends up here for the weekend. We're going to hang out. But I'm about to pass my grandparents' place. Get a little clip of it, and I'm going to stop at the cemetery and do a little video on one of our family graves. This is where the Keiths, my family Keith, Silva and Annie Keith, moved in the 40s. It's on Bohannon Creek. It is about a mile and a half west of Whitesburg. Whitesboro. That's the cemetery. First place is right here. There's my grandparents' graves. Silva Otis Keith and my grandma Annie Lee Cobbler Keith are buried here. This is go overseas. I've researched it. He was at a depot where they got the soldiers ready to ship to France. It was over in Arkansas. That's where he was stationed. And then next to their grave is their mother, Lena A. Kite. Lena Martin was her maiden name. She was married several times, so it was Lena Martin Keith Clark Kite. So she didn't have any kids with Kite, but she had a son with Clark, and she had several sons and daughters with Keith. There's some more graves up there. I'll go up there. This is a grave of Lynn Thompson, who is a baby of Minnie Thompson, Minnie Keith. Minnie was the daughter of Orville Cornelius Keith. And this is another grave of one of her children. They didn't live when they were born. But Minnie and Ruby Keith came with Orville and Robert Tabor, which is Silva and Ben and Florida's father. They came here. Ruby is buried in Big Cedar in the cemetery there. It took me a long time to find her, but I found her. She died when she was 13. She got sick. Now, this is where my mom's brothers are buried, up here in the corner. Alvin Ray Keith, Ray Keith. That's May Keith's twin brother. May's still alive. And then this is Cletus Ray Perry. This is May's husband. This is their stone. May will be buried beside him. And here is Herman Keith and his wife Charlotte. And right behind them, this is Thurl Haskell Keith. Everybody called him Hack. Miss them all. This is my grandmother Annie, you know, Annie Lee Cobbler Keith, her sister Lily Cobbler. She married Elijah Johnson. Elijah was a brother of Mac Johnson, who was married to Florida May Keith, Grandpa's older sister. These are their kids. William Holleran Johnson, William David Johnson. Right here, these unmarked graves are actually Grandma's father, Jefferson Cobbler, her stepmothers, Anna, Ada, Alabama, McKay Cobbler, and then Grandma had a little sister named Willie, like 2 years old, died. And this is Grandma's brother, George Cobbler. I'm gonna try to mark these graves as one of my projects when I'm retired. And I forgot, back down there by the Thompsons is also Charles Melvin Keith, Grandma's or Grandpa's little brother, the one that died with appendicitis when he's like 20 years old. Town of Whitesboro. It's where my mom went to high school. Most of them, all of them did. Graduated from here. It's a little bitty spot in the road. These little bitty houses here, these rock houses, my grandpa built those. Silva Keith. Still standing. Not much of a town. Very little. Right when you're leaving town, right up here on the right is where my mother was born. There used to be an old shack up here. That's where they lived. It was on that hill right over there, that open spot, right behind this corral. Right over there behind that mobile home. And her and Herman were born there, her brother Herman Keith. That's before they moved to the other place. Well, they were born quite a bit earlier. They were born, she was born 27. They didn't get to place down around Bohannon Creek till like 1940 or 42. I don't remember the exact date. They'd moved around a lot between then. They lived down by Tallahena and back over on the river where they finally got that place. There's another place my grandpa Silva helped build. This old church, that part of it, Rock Church. Coming into the town of Muse, which is even a smaller spot in the road than Whitesboro. This is the Muse Cemetery. He and his wife were buried here, Melba. Melba just died this last year. Angie. They're buried here. They lived in Muse, and that's why they're here.